accept what term? Any quick start in your computer?
What?
Quick start on your computer.
Taking care of the environment.
Okay. Giselle? Any understanding?
No one knows.
Okay, so today's topic is about camera shots and how it can affect the way we feel about characters or scenes. You can look this thing in your screen.
Oh, yes.
Just click start. And how might different camera shots be used to create different moods or tones in the scene? And how can it be used to highlight or emphasize certain elements in the scene, such as objects or characters? Also, can it be used to challenge or undermine audience expectations in the movie or television? So this person here, we have a certain name for this kind of shot.
A close-up.
Yeah? It's a close-up.
Yes. So that's why we whatever we learned last time, remember we learned about camera movement, but camera movement goes with the shots. Okay? You wanna sit on the chair? I can give you a chair.
Yeah, okay.
Come here, close. So camera shot is about how you place your character or your object or your subject in the frame of the camera. That's what we call the camera shot. How camera shot have been used here? Did you notice anything unusual? You can just raise your hand. How do you feel? Who was the important person? You can just raise your hand, you don't have to write anything here. Just tell me. Random? May I have your phone? Please. May I have your phone as well? Yes. Brandon, please, in my class, when I say put away your devices, please. So tell me, the way you saw, how did you notice anything?
Did you show all the characters in motion?
You love to see. Just a couple of stitches. Take your chair. I'm listening to
you. It's like a closer shot.
Yes. Do you know closer shot of what? Who was the important person?
Just other characters in motion.
I'm pretty sure I know which shots were used.
Sorry?
I think I know which shots were used.
Yeah. So you can just check.
Close up, medium, wide shot, and
have been used in that shot
of
the wedding. Yes, Max?
I felt like Wednesday is cringe and you can turn off the volume.
Wednesday is what?
Wednesday is cringe. You can turn off the volume.
Okay. And Austin, who's joining you?
So like the camera
the shot
in cube though, like made like one person more important than the other.
Yeah.
Alright. Alright, guys, I think Austin and Sean get like very close to the video. One person was more important, and we see the person is on the center all the time.
It's Tyler.
Yes. So, and that is happen also in the stone. We see that the stone in the middle was in the middle of the whole shot, and then and it was more important, and then when it was about to be removed, meaning that importance of that stone is no longer there, it was moving away slowly and slowly. When people are kicking it, it was moving away of the shot slowly and slowly. Did you notice that?
Yeah. Hey, out of curiosity, did you ever watch Wednesday?
I watched one episode.
You agree that Tyler and Wednesday
would have
been a good couple?
I didn't watch
it. They would have been a good couple. They would have, but then Tyler just had to be a murderer.
But that is not the topic.
Yeah,
okay.
Okay,
Max. So, guys, did you notice about movement of the stone slowly, slowly out away of the shot, of the center of the shot? You put the character or the object, the subject in the middle of the shot, meaning that is very important, and especially when it's covered the whole shot, all right? So we have different kind of shots. In the movie, we have establishing shot. This establishing shot, Catherine, can you come and sit here? In the movie, we have an establishing shot. Establishing shot is the shot that establishes the location and the movie, where the movie is happening, what that everything is happening. And then we have the master shot. The master shot is like if somebody takes a shot, for example, this camera here is taking out the master shot. Ayos. Ayos. You want to sit on your place? Yeah? Can you sit closer to me here? Thank you. The master shot is the shot that shows everything that's happening in one single scene, all right? And then we have a wide shot, and then we have full shot, cowboy shot, medium close-up shot, and extreme close-up shot. Cowboy shot? How do you remember? I didn't speak about it.
I know.
Take pencils over here.
The cowboy shot is used to show
go and sit on your own because we don't have video, so go and sit on your own.
Yeah, a grass ball, like throw
it. Yeah, the tumbleweed.
I don't want it. The movie
I'm
not going to write anything on it.
So this is full shot. We see the full shot from the toe to the head, head to the toe, and all those other shots, okay? Any questions so far? If I ask you, what is MCU, medium close-up shot? Can you tell me? Creepy. Medium close-up shot.
Chest.
Upward, right?
Okay.
Yes, you're very right. And close-up shot?
That's called chest.
Shoulder? Upward, right? You're right. Close-up shot. It's from the shoulder. Okay. Okay? Upward. So some people start from the neck sometimes. Okay? And extreme close-up?
It's like the eye.
The eye is the part of the... And these
show intense emotions.
And these two shots, close-up shots and extreme close-up, they are more, they are talking about emotions. For example, someone is angry, someone is crying, someone is sad. You show extreme close-up, okay?
Or to build intensity.
And remember when we were doing camera movement, for example, zooming is used mostly to capture the extreme close-up. So for example, three of us, me, Maggie, and Catherine, we are sitting together talking, and maybe Maggie is like thinking home and feeling sad or something. And then the camera zoom slowly, because the slow motion, remember I told you about movement, slow motion shows also a lot of emotions. So camera can zoom slowly to Maggie's eyes to create extreme close-up that shows the emotion.
With a full shot, It's not necessary to put the subject in the center of the frame, but notice how often this is the case. This example is effective because it is tight enough to tell a story with the character's face, but wide enough to further the story by observing her entire body posture.
So in your groups, I'm putting this assignment in your group, guys. Can I play? Are you ready, guys?
Yeah.
You this group, are you ready?
All right, let's go. Let's ace this. Dun, 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 dun.
Number one. What kind of shot you got? Number two. That's number two. What kind of shot you got? Plenty of time. Are you done? We have plenty of time. Alright, let's see our answers. Right, white shot is okay.
Can I go to storyboard.com?
Yeah, you can do it if you go to storyboard.com. Just take shots with your phone and then put them there. Use your phone and
take the outside shots.
You can take after shot and then pass over there.
Oh, Chris, look at this one.
Show me. What is it? What did you take?
I forgot. Establish.
How did you take the established one?
So the established is the
Alan. Alan, can you stop it and go back to class?
And then the character is very small, right?
The establishing shot, you don't see the character. It's only the location.
The other one, the wide shot.
Wide or long, yes, the character.
Wide or long.
So was it speed, now shot size.
Choose a scene that you are interested in. Yeah, and then write down the camera movement and the camera shots and the warping effect.
Body language, dialogue, right? So here you see the body language, the way they communicate each other, alright? So those are the
space for what object?
The queen!
So,
the queen!
Go to that
the
space.
Queen!
For what?
The queen!
You can see the shots, right? In this department. And then here you explain what